And now here comes the teaching of the Vedas. Hinduism firmly asserts that there is something permanent behind this entire changing world. There is something permanent behind the changing us. Our bodies keep on changing, our minds keep on changing, but behind and beyond these two, there is something shining that is the eternal principle, the Atman. That this world is ever-changing is known to all of us. Those who were there before are not there now. We ourselves keep on changing our focus of love and hate. In childhood, we love some people, now we love others. So everything is changing. Our bodies keep on changing. The world outside keeps on changing. Everything changes. But still, there is something unchanging which we do not know. That something is the self or Atman. That is the real we and not the changing things. Now, take a little break from this and look at things scientifically. When we say there is permanence in something, although everything else is impermanent that we view around us, even that permanent thing that we feel that the religions talk about may in fact be impermanent itself. It's just impermanent on such a vast time scale that it may as well be permanent to us. Research in Big Bang Theory and inflationary cosmology show that, even if there are multiverses and things repeat themselves, it dies down. There may not actually be some level of permanence, but that's irrelevant to our human timescale. If there is no such thing as permanence on any level, there is still something whose impermanence is so slow that if we take the limit mathematically, let's say, you're going to get to permanence. Now, there are stages of happiness. There's an old story of a woodcutter. He used to cut wood in the forest, sell it, and earn money. One day, he met a monk on the way. The monk told him, "Go forward. That's all." The woodcutter didn't understand the teaching. He went to the forest and began cutting wood. Suddenly, he remembered the monk's words, "Go forward." "Let me go forward, then," he says. He went a little forward. There, to his surprise, he saw sandalwood. He was astonished. "Ah, all these days I was only selling ordinary wood. If I had known this place, I could have made much money," he thought. Then he began cutting wood there. Some time later, he again remembered the monk's words, "Go forward." And he went further into the forest. He was surprised to see a mine of gold. Now, Hinduism is positive in approach to life and its various aspects. It does not say this world is miserable, etc. Or it may not admit it. It says that what we are enjoying is happiness. It's happiness, all right. But there are higher and higher forms of happiness. So let's say, even if you're not a negative state of mind, as Buddhism may imply it to be, which in all reality is not negative, but let's say you can't handle, for a moment, a lot of people can't, considering that the world is misery, and you need to focus on the positive. Oh, everything's a miracle. It's a miracle. My children are a miracle. Everything is great. Don't do it in a delusionary fashion. It is okay. Now, accept that, yes, things are great, but things can be better. And it is not okay to settle. To continuously focus on, "Let me settle and be comfortable here," is eventually going to rear the ugly head of unhappiness. You need to be consistently taking action. So Hinduism takes a more positive approach to the same thing and says that the world is not miserable. We are enjoying happiness from moment to moment, but there are higher forms of happiness, and sometimes you have to let go of this in order to gain that. Sun Tzu in The Art of War says only a fool is not able to let go of this to gain that. You need to go for it. Don't stop where you are. Go forward, go forward, go forward, go forward. There are higher and higher aspects of happiness. Get them. I know this may be contradictory to other teachings in happiness where it says settle for where you are, except this is not the case. And this is why you have probably achieved happiness, states of bliss, through other teachings, but they were only temporary. Don't settle. Contrary to the advice that we get, don't settle. Settling sounds practical, but practical people are not as practical as they think they are when compared to people who follow their dreams. There is always better. Always. So go forward. And the key to going forward may not be manipulating things around you in the external world. More meditation. If you feel like something is wrong with your life, listen to yourself. Meditate. There may be something wrong. There are higher and higher aspects of happiness. Get them. According to the Vedas, there is a gradual increase in happiness as we evolve in life. Worldly happiness, mental happiness, spiritual happiness. In this world, we sing, we dance, we drink, we enjoy, we eat, and do everything we can. As hedonistic as that sounds, that hedonism is a stage of life, according to Hinduism. All these joys put together can be called one type of happiness. Stage one. In this world, however much we may try, however much wealth we may have, however much enjoyments we may have, all our enjoyments will be only to some extent. Not much. Let us say it is to be equal to if a person lives in this world without diseases, having a perfect body and enjoying everything every moment, his joy can be compared to stage one, or one on some sort of graduated continuum. Stage two. We all believe in some heaven or bliss. What is the type of heavenly pleasure? In the higher worlds, the happiness will be equal to 100 times more than this world. If the joy we get here is one, then which we get in heaven is 100. But both these joys are temporary. We have sufficient experience in this world of such temporary joy to understand this truth. You have experienced it. That's why you've bought yet again another book on happiness.